God.
Before we begin to answer this question, we have to understand what God means to us. What is the meaning? So in most cultures and in most religions, God is seen as a superhuman figure, usually male, and he's seen as someone who protects us, who plans our lives. He has a great plan for our lives, and we are just, you know, doing his will. He decides who's doing the right action, who's doing the wrong action. He rewards, he punishes, and he's always watching over us like a very fond father. So that is the concept of a God. And when bad things happen to people, it's very difficult to believe in that concept of a God. You're saying, if God is good, if God is goodness and God is love, why do bad things happen to people? And why do so many bad things happen to even good people? So then it becomes a difficult thing to answer. How do I know that God exists if all this bad stuff is happening in the world? And that's a valid question. Now, in the Hindu conception, the Indian conception of God is not of a person at all. The concept of God in Indian philosophy, in Hindu philosophy, is that of a force, a cosmic energy that keeps everything vitally alive. Okay, and it is genderless. It's not a he or a she. It is formless. You know, we may give it forms. We may think of it in a form of a Shiva or a Vishnu or a Shakti, Parvati or Ganesha. We can think of a God in many forms. But the God, the capital G-O-D, has no form at all. And it's also nameless. Again, we can give many names to our gods because we want to, you know, approach them as people, as somebody like us, as friends, as mothers, as lovers, as children. We want to approach them in a particular way. But actually, the original concept of God is genderless, formless, nameless. Energy, a cosmic energy that keeps everything moving in the universe, that makes sure the trees flower and fruit, and they grow from tiny seeds. How does that happen? Where does that energy come from? It's the cosmic energy. How does rain come? Because of a whole cycle of the water cycle. How do animals know what to do from the time they are little babies, little cubs? The animal can stand up and start doing things. How? What is that energy that gives it the power to move? What is it that keeps the sun shining every day and making sure it never calls in sick saying, hey, I can't come into work today? That never happens, because there's a cosmic energy, a cosmic force making sure that all these things keep happening. And that is the same cosmic force that makes us wake up in the morning. In fact, the Upanishads say that you have that same vital spark of energy in you, every single one of us. And therefore, we are all gods. We all have the potential to be God. We have that divine spark. And once you realize that, once that spark leaves a body, the body looks exactly the same as it did 1 minute ago. But once that spark has left, whether it's from an animal or a bird or a human, that person is no longer the person he or she was, that no longer the animal he was, no longer the bird he was. So there is some vital, divine, cosmic energy in each of us that keeps us alive and keeps everything around us in constant, glorious motion. If that is our concept of a God, it's very easy to believe in, because you can see it at work around you in yourself every single day.